Rod Serling.
You're traveling through another dimension, a dimension not only of sight and sound, but of mind. A journey into a wondrous land whose boundaries are those of imagination. Your next stop, the Twilight Zone.
My name is Archibald Beechcraft, and to coin a phrase, welcome to my world. And a wonderful world it is. You might even call it paradise. To tell you the truth, I don't remember exactly how I got here, but I assure you I have no intentions of leaving. No intentions whatsoever. Why should I? Everything I need is here. The sand, the sea, the sky, as blue as a robin's egg, gently swaying palms, and absolutely nothing on the horizon. Nothing. And no one. Do you understand? Not a soul in sight as far as the eye can see. Only the occasional bottle that washes up on the beach. Like this one. They're all the same. With a note inside, some poor soul scribbling a message for help. Whoever reads this, I am stranded on a desert island. Please send a rescue ship at once. Stranded? A rescue ship? The fool! Doesn't he know he's finally found peace? He's escaped from the crowds, the rat race, from civilization. Obviously an imbecile. Who would want to go back to that world? Cars, subways, buses, and people. Everywhere you look, yammering away, pushing and shoving till you can't breathe, can't think. No thanks. I've had my fill of people. If you don't mind, I'll live out my days like this. Alone. Quite blissfully alone. Except, of course, for Chi-Chi, the perfect companion. Never a word of disagreement. In fact, never a word of any kind, because, you see, he's a chimpanzee. And a very intelligent one. If I'm hungry, he brings me a banana. When I'm thirsty, he climbs a tree and picks a ripe coconut. Have you ever tasted fresh coconut milk? Oh, you must. It's really quite refreshing. Hold on, Chi-Chi. What's this? A footprint? Well, that means we're not alone after all. But how can that be? This is my world! Wait a minute. Whoever made this footprint, do you suppose his name might be Friday? If so, he'll speak an entirely different language. No communication whatsoever, and plenty of room for both of us. He'll have his half of the island, and I'll have mine. Unless, of course, Friday's a female. You think it's possible? Why, I don't see why not. A lovely native girl in a sarong with big brown eyes like a Walter Keane painting, and a tray of finger sandwiches, poi, that sort of thing. Maybe some Mai Tais. Who can't speak, of course. No, no, why should she? She'll live in her grass hut, and I'll live in mine, and we'll visit from time to time. An ideal arrangement. I'll give her a lei, a flower lei, whenever the spirit moves me. And when the spirit doesn't move me... Now, where's that coming from? There aren't any telephones on my island. It can't be. A telephone booth on the beach? Most ridiculous thing I've ever seen. Yes? Yes, who is it? Who in the... Hello, who's there? Hello? Who? Hello? Tropical Paradise, Beechcraft speaking. Hello? Hello? Oh, the alarm clock. I must have been dreaming again. What time is it? 6:30 already? This is my world, all right. And welcome to it.
A brief, if somewhat jarring, introduction to Mr. Archibald Beechcraft. A child of his time. A product of the population explosion. And an unwilling inheritor of the legacy of progress. He has just begun his daily battle for survival in a world that cares not one whit for his happiness or sanity. But very soon, our hero will begin a one-man rebellion against this impersonal age. And to do so, he will enlist the help of certain unusual aids of the sort found only in the Twilight Zone.
And now, The Twilight Zone and our story, The Mind and the Matter, starring Hal Sparks, with Stacy Keach as your narrator.
Morning, Beechcraft.
I don't see what's so good about it.
How's that?
If you'll excuse me, I'm late.
You're always late. Take it easy. You'll get there.
I'm sure I will. And what an unmitigated joy that will be.
91, 92, 93.
Stand aside.
I don't have to. My mom said I could play.
And I said move it.
94, 95, 96, 97.
Why do you have to do that here, inside the building?
Oh, you made me lose count. Now I have to start all over again. 1, 2, 3.
Get out of my way, you little wretch!
Ma, that man called me a wretch!
Hey, watch it, buddy.
Sorry.
Look where you're going.
Beg your pardon.
Hey, careful with the briefcase, huh?
I'm late, you see.
Hey, he almost knocked me down.
If I miss my train...
Red light, mister, red light.
But I can't wait for the light to change. If I do miss my train, then they'll dock my pay, meager though it may be. And if they do that, well, there's no limit to what they can do. I'm not about to jeopardize my position just because of all the rude, inconsiderate people who are ruining this city. Positively ruining. That's my train!
Slow down, one at a time.
But you see, officer, I absolutely must catch the 732 uptown.
Keep your shirt on, pal.
Let me through, please.
Watch who you're pushing.
You don't understand. This is my...
Hands off, buddy.
One person per token.
I don't have a token.
Well, then you better get one at the window.
But I overslept. I'm late.
One at a time, folks. Let's keep moving.
Let me on, please.
Hey, you stepped on my foot.
Move to the back, please.
This elevator's full.
But I absolutely must get to the 15th floor.
Why don't you wait for the next one?
I can't wait. I'm late as it is.
I said this one's full.
Surely there's room for one more.
Sorry, Beechcraft.
If I could just squeeze in.
Will you watch the elbow?
I do apologize.
Going up.
There's Mr. Beechcraft. Finally decided to make it, hmm?
Better late than never.
Morning, Laura.
What happened to you?
What didn't? You'd been through what I've been through.
Did you punch in?
Yes.
Mr. Rogers got here 15 minutes ago.
I'm sure he did.
I told him you went to get coffee.
Coffee? That's what I need.
Not now.
And my blood pressure pills.
Wait till the break. Look like you're busy.
You mean pretend? I don't have to pretend. Of course, in a reasonable world where a person could work at his own pace with no pressure, no interruptions.
Mr. Rogers will be back any minute.
I'll bet he will. All right. Where did I leave off yesterday? The Campbell file, as I recall.
I'm finishing it for you.
What? You shouldn't have done that. I'm quite capable.
I know you are. I was only trying to help.
Thank you, Laura. But if I could be allowed to concentrate without so many distractions, there'd be no problem.
Here's your coffee, Miss Petty.
Oh, thank you, Henry. You can call me Laura, you know.
All right, Laura. I didn't know how you wanted it, so I got cream and sugar. Is that okay?
That's fine.
Kindly give it back.
Hmm?
The Campbell file.
I'm just about to close it out.
Where do you want me to set it?
What?
The coffee.
Just a minute.
If you please, Laura.
Here you go.
Oh, no. Why, you clumsy clod!
Gosh, Mr. Beechcraft... I sure am sorry.
You spilled it all over my jacket.
I guess I didn't see you.
That's precisely your problem.
Try cold water before the stain sets.
I'll get another cup.
That's all right, Henry. No harm done.
I ought to send you the cleaning bill.
Is that Beechcraft?
Yes, sir.
Looks like he's headed for the washroom. Something the matter?
Well, Mr. Rogers, you see,
He's a little out of sorts this morning.
Is he now? Feeling ill, Beechcraft?
Hmm? No, sir. Nothing like that.
If you'll forgive an observation, you're not looking too well.
I'm all right, Mr. Rogers.
You look tired. You know, Beechcraft, keeping yourself fit is not only a personal responsibility. In a larger sense, it's part of your obligation to the firm that employs you. Healthy body, healthy mind, and so forth?
I'm not unaware of that.
Then why don't you pull yourself together, man? Get enough sleep at night.
I try to, sir.
Eat regular meals. Lots of fresh vegetables, greens. Oh, you can't beat those greens for vitamins. I'm a sprouts and spinach man myself.
Are you?
I'd have them for breakfast if I could. Believe me, Beechcraft, the secret is definitely in the greens. It's the color of power.
I see.
Not drinking, are you, Beechcraft? Touch of the old sauce?
I don't drink, Mr. Rogers.
Well, if you don't drink and you don't stay out late at night, you must not be watching your diet. From now on, see that you do.
If you'd really like to know, Mr. Rogers, if you'd really like to know precisely why I'm so dead tired, try coming to work on the 732 subway train every morning, then jamming into an elevator with a herd of cattle, then trying to work in that den of cacophony you call an office.
Take hold of yourself, Beechcraft.
Then standing in line in that so-called cafeteria during that so-called lunch hour, which is never more than 42 minutes. Oh, that's really good for the digestion. Then getting trampled to death in the subway again at 5:38 every night. Then standing in line with more people at a greasy spoon restaurant, followed by another line at a movie or a concert or anywhere else I care to go. But always standing in line, always getting shoved, always getting jostled, always getting pushed around by more people.
For goodness sakes, man, take hold.
I'll take hold, Mr. Rogers. I'll take hold when I can achieve that milestone, that millennium, that absolute perfection that only comes with solitude. Understand? Solitude. That means no people. You read me, Mr. Rogers? They're the ultimate insult. And my problem is simply that I can't get away from them. At no time, except during the wondrous 7.5 hours I spend in my bed every night. And even then, I hear them outside.
Hear what?
People. Raucous, shrieking, shouting people. Herds, droves, legions, hosts, armies, bevies, flocks and coveys of people, people, people!
I don't like that look in your eye, Beechcraft. I don't like it one bit.
If I had my way, here's how I'd fix the universe. I'd eliminate them all. I mean, cross them off. Get rid of them. Send them packing. Destroy them. And then there'd be only one man left. Me. Archibald Beechcraft, Esquire. Let me out of here.
You're quite mad. Do you know that, Beechcraft? You're either off or en route away from your rocker.
Well, if I am, I very much prefer my madness to the so-called sanity around me. People, as far as I'm concerned, you can have them. If I had my way, I'd make them all disappear. Every last one.
Well, well, well. Old Beechcraft's finally showing some gumption. Just the same, I'd best keep a close eye on him. A very close eye indeed.
I'll have a baked fish.
Yes, ma'am.
Salisbury steak for me.
Coming right up.
Oh, and an extra roll.
Vegetables with that?
Broccoli.
Sure thing.
No mashed potatoes, no french fries, no... I'll have the succotash today.
Club sandwich here.
Dessert?
How's the tapioca pudding?
Lumpy.
I need another fork. This one's dirty.
You got it.
One club sandwich, coleslaw, no fries, coffee black.
There you go.
That's it, sir.
That's right, the usual.
So I see. Cash or charge?
Cash. Wallet out of my pocket. There's hardly room to turn around. Here.
Don't you have anything smaller?
No, I'm afraid not.
Your change.
Hurry up, will you, buddy? We don't have all day.
I'm doing my best. If you'd allow me to put my wallet away.
Next, one double macaroni and cheese, salad with ranch.
Excuse me.
The seat's saved.
Well, how about the one next to it?
No, he'll be right back.
Of course. Of course he will.
Hey, Mr. Beechcraft, over here.
Thank God. I'm obliged, Henry.
Think nothing of it, Mr. Beechcraft. Squeeze right in.
That was my plan.
Been saving it for you. I was sort of... Well, I wanted to make up for this morning.
This morning?
When I spilled coffee on your coat. I'm really sorry about that. Say, Mr. Beechcraft?
Mm-hmm.
I have a friend.
You don't say.
Works in the used bookstore around the corner. I went there before lunch.
Whatever for?
Oh, I like to read. All kinds of stuff.
Do tell.
Horror, mostly. That's my favorite.
Why am I not surprised?
Some of those paperbacks are pretty cool, you know? There was one about these giant worms that live in the sub-sub-basement of an office building. And if you took the elevator down there late at night, these big old white old worm things will be waiting for you. And they must have been really hungry, because...
Please, Henry. I'm eating.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, I went over there today, and I saw this. So I sort of got it for you.
What is it? Story of a serial killer who wants to depopulate the Earth?
Nothing like that. Take a look. I thought you might like it.
The mind and the matter. How you can achieve the ultimate power of concentration. Think this is something I need, Henry?
It's really rare. There are only a few printed.
A little on the occult side, isn't it?
Maybe so. But seeing as how you always have so much work to do, my friend is kind of a student of the mind. He swears by this. Says it's the last copy. The publisher was supposed to destroy all of them.
For what reason?
Too powerful. Tells you how to make people do things.
Thing?
Would you believe it, Mr. Beechcraft? I've seen him. I've seen my friend cause a woman to do... to do something fantastic.
How's that?
It's true. He was in a department store, and he saw this woman at the sale table, and he concentrated real hard on one particular thing, and... Mr. Beechcraft, as sure as I'm sitting here in the cafeteria of the United Tool and Die Company, that woman... You won't believe this.
What?
Well, that woman picked up a chartreuse and orange scarf, paid for it and everything. She never would have bought it in a million years. Who would? But he made her do it, just like that. It's the truth, I swear.
Will you please try to be more careful?
Oops, there goes the coffee again. Sorry, Mr. Beechcraft.
Thank you so much for the book, Henry. Now, if you don't mind, I think I'll be leaving. I've had more than my fill.
Mr. Beechcraft, chapter 3. Read that one first. Remember, chapter 3.
Right, Henry. Chapter 3. Initial phenomenon of intense concentration. Focus on a single desired outcome, then close your eyes, mental picture, repeat 3 times.
Ready to go back?
Not yet. I have to fix my makeup.
Okay.
Wait, I think I'll have a soda first. Want one?
Nah.
Let me see. Orange, root beer, grape.
Might as well give it a try. Concentrate. Tropical punch. Pick tropical punch.
I just can't make up my mind.
It's delicious. Try it. You'll like it.
Why'd you pick that one?
I don't know. I really don't. I was going to choose lemon lime, but for some reason my finger pressed tropical punch.
How's it taste?
Might as well find out.
Yes! You'll see. It's absolutely delicious. Puts one in the mind of a Mai Tai. I think I'd better read the entire book. Chapter 4, to achieve your heart's desire. Heart's desire, eh? Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. The most important element is concentration. Blot out the quotidian irrelevancies that pollute your day. Quotidian? Nice vocabulary.
Mr. Beechcraft?
The science of the mind requires absolute adherence to the following rules.
Mr. Beechcraft?
What is it, Laura?
Did you turn in the Campbell file?
Campbell?
John R. From this morning. I don't see it.
I'll get to it. Now then. The following rules of mental control over the omnipresent phenomenology of the modern environment.
I really need the file before Mr. Rogers comes by again.
Silence! Did you say I'm reading?
Sorry I disturbed you.
Oh, Laura, how is your beverage, by the way?
Beverage?
In the hall, the can of soda. Tropical punch, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Not bad, actually. Reminded me of a piña colada.
Did it now. Delicious, I bet. I'll just get back to my book. Very important book. Very, very important. Distractions which divert 98% of our brain capacity from the more highly evolved regions of the cerebral cortex.
Thank you. everybody going to the ground floor?
Yeah.
The source of the power is located in the pineal gland, or vestigial third eye.
You, sir?
Where the power of the all-encompassing life force...
Sir, you going to the first floor, too?
He's talking to you, buddy. What's the matter, you deaf?
What? Of course I'm going to the first floor. Where else would I be going?
Watch your fingers. Going down.
The more complete the mental picture, the more complete the result. Focus your mind and concentrate to the exclusion of all else. From the lower to the higher chakras, until you feel the power surging.
You getting on the train or what?
Hmm? Oh, yes, yes.
Then move along.
All aboard!
Mental imaging of the desired result to the exclusion of all else.
Now where was I? Chapter 9. The energy generated by pure mind has an electrical coefficient of... Yes. Yes, mm-hmm. The numbers are absolutely correct. Unequivocally. That being the case, it stands to reason that the conclusions are correct as well. Why, the mind must be the most underrated power in the entire universe. Given the proper concentration, well, there's really no limit to what a man could do. No limit at all. Look at them down there. People. So many. I wonder, if I concentrated hard enough, could I actually get rid of... Why not? Why not? Concentration, that's all it takes. I have the power here, inside my head. Sheer concentration. Concentrate on getting rid of all those people. I wonder if I could do it in one fell swoop. Or knock them off one by one. Just think of it. Nobody in the elevator, in the office, the cafeteria, or on the street. None! Not in the hall, or on the stairs. Nobody except...
Mr. Beechcraft.
Who is it?
You know perfectly well who it is. It's Mrs. Weller. The rent is due, Mr. Beechcraft. Do you hear me? The rent. I'm not going away till you pay, Mr. Beechcraft. Mr. Beechcraft.
Close your eyes and repeat the following words 3 times. Go away. Disappear. Be extinct.
The rent, Mr. Beechcraft.
Go away. Disappear. Be extinct.
The rent!
Go away. Disappear. Be extinct.
Mr. Beach!
Mrs. Weller?
Mrs. Weller? Mrs. Weller? Aha! You're gone!
Concentration, that's the key. And I have it.
Today the landlady, tomorrow the world!
Good morning, Beechcraft.
Is it?
I only meant...
I know perfectly well what you meant. Why don't you just keep to yourself and mind your own beeswax?
Well... I don't know why I bother, Beechcraft. I was only trying to be a good neighbor. I've tried to be a good neighbor for years, and what good does it do me? Why don't
go
you keep
away,
yourself from now
disappear,
on? I'll stay in my
be extinct.
And you stay in
go
yours,
away,
never the twain
disappear,
meet, okay?
Be
that
extinct.
Suit you because it suits...
Aha! I wasn't dreaming! It works!
116.
Out of the way, son.
Make me. 117.
Very well. Go away, disappear, be extinct. Go away, disappear, be extinct.
Hey, give me back my ball.
I don't have your ball, young man.
Then where did it go?
Ma!
Silence!
Ma, the
bandit
took
my I'm afraid you leave me
ball.
No choice. Go away, disappear,
Ma,
be
he won't give it
extinct.
Back. He won't.
And another one bites the dust.
Hey, watch it.
Out of the way, jerk.
I was here first.
Let me through, please. I need to catch the 732.
Officer, that man cut in front of me.
Hey, you!
I said you!
Surely you're not addressing me.
Put a token in like everybody else.
I don't have a token.
So get one.
I don't have time to buy tokens. If I miss my train...
Step out of the line.
What for?
I'm writing you up. You're going to get a big fat fine for cheating the city out of...
But it's only a token. I'll mail it to you. I'll deposit 2 tokens tomorrow morning, but I simply do not have the time.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I heard it all before.
This one may take some doing.
What'd you say?
Nothing, officer. Concentrate. Go away, disappear, be extinct.
Are you cursing me out?
Go away, disappear, be extinct.
All right, that's it. I'm taking you in for insulting a transit officer. I got a nice pair of bracelets that'll fit you just fine.
Go away, disappear, be extinct. You were saying, officer? You were saying? All right, 732, let's get ready to rumble. Beechcraft is coming through. What? No line for the elevator this morning? No pushing? No shoving? My, my, that is unusual. Anyone else? No? All right then. Going up? Morning, everyone. Laura? Ah, you're not here, are you? Slept in, I presume? Like a great many people. Fine with me. I'll just sit down here and get to work without being rushed. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Jones Stephen. A rather large export to the UK. I'll just see if everything's in order. At my own pace, for once. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes. Better finish this one before Mr. Rogers gets here. If he ever shows up. Now, let me see. All well and good. Well and good. A major improvement. Only, when I finish this and the other files, what else is there to do? With no one breathing down my neck, how should one occupy his time? Isn't it time for lunch yet? I think I'll just have the salad today. Some soup to start off and crackers. No hurry, mind you. Plenty of time to digest my meal. Where to sit? Why, any table at all? The morning paper. What's new in the world today? White House? Middle East? Federal Reserve Bank? Oh, it's no use. I hate eating alone. And worse than that, I'm bored. If only I had someone to talk to. One person, that's all. Someone quiet, well-mannered, intelligent. Someone like me, in other words. That's it. Concentrate, Beechcraft, concentrate. You called? It worked. Of course it worked. Don't you have any confidence in yourself? Pleased to meet you. The name's Beechcraft. I know. And your name is? Archibald. Call me Archie. You too. I mean, call me Archie as well, if you like. I like it just fine. How's tricks, Arch, old man? Bit on the slow side this morning. Look here, Arch. This isn't working. Wouldn't you agree? Why not? Let's be frank. Too much of a good thing. Well, I wouldn't say so. But you're thinking it. Let's just say I'm temporarily accessible to suggestions about how to occupy my time. Face it, you're bored to tears. Solitude is one thing, but loneliness... Loneliness is quite another. Loneliness. I despise people. Loathe them. And I, Archibald Beechcraft, have done away with them. For good and all, mind you, for good and all. I'm leaving. You haven't finished your lunch. I don't have much of an appetite. Thought about any alternatives? Alternatives to what? To this. It's like an empty movie set in here. I don't even want to think about what it's like outside. Look at yourself. You don't have idea one about how to fill the day. People are bad enough, but inactivity's even worse. You're talking nonsense. I'm content. I'm honestly and truly content for the first time in my life. I have managed to rid myself of the worst scourge there is. The general populace. So what are you going to do? Splurge and buy a can of tropical fruit punch from the soft drink machine? Will that do it for you? If the truth be known, I would like... Well, I would appreciate a little diversion of some kind. Any kind. You mean like a change in the weather? That's it. Perhaps a little unseasonal rain. Or a lot of rain. Let's make it... A tropical storm with thunder and lightning. The works. That should shake things up. All I have to do is concentrate. Not that exciting, is it? Maybe we need to add something spectacular. Like an earthquake. Sure you want to do that? Why not? Here goes. You mean there it goes? I can imagine what the office looks like right now. My desk! All your files on the floor. Gonna take some sorting. Enough! No earthquake and no storm either. Forget it! So now what, Arch, old man? I've had it for the day. I'm gonna take the rest of the afternoon off. Uh-huh. And do what? Stroll down the street? Take a ride on the subway all by your lonesome? Boy, I'll bet the old apartment building's quiet as a tomb. It's starting to get to you, isn't it? The thing of it is, I don't care much for people, but it's difficult not having anyone. Present company excluded. I guess it's a trade-off. That's the crux of the problem. Frankly, there isn't a breed of human being that I can stomach. Ever think of a Cocker Spaniel? I never cared much for animals either. Most of all, though, I can't stand people. Thanks. Well, except for you, naturally. But that's because you're a higher class of individual. Wait a minute. That's it! That's what? Why didn't I think of it before? People I can stand. That's what I'll do. I'll create people who are just like me. A world full of Archie Beechcrafts. Now that's a thought. You bet your sweet life it is. I'll will it. I'll concentrate. And from now on, everyone will be exactly like me. It's so simple. And when will this new era be ushered in? Tomorrow morning. I'll repeople the earth. Nothing but my kind of folks. In fact, why wait? How about right now? 15th floor. Everybody off. Look at them. Like sardines. Rude, thoughtless people. Worthless. Every last one.
Nobody has any manners nowadays.
Late. Thanks to them.
Listen to them. They sound just like me.
You're not kidding. Take a gander at their faces. They look like us, too. A rather handsome lot, you must admit. Where are they headed? Back to work, I presume, those who chose not to dine in the cafeteria.
A sight for sore eyes, eh, Archie?
It certainly is. Now that I've decided to replenish the population in a kinder, gentler mold. This, I gotta see. United Tool and Die, one moment, please.
Rude son of noise, the miserable noise.
I'll go out of my ever-loving mind. Keep it down, I'm trying to work.
Can't hear myself think. People, 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 is there no respite?
Herds, droves, legions, armies, hosts, bevies, coveys of people. Deliver me, please deliver me.
Hear that, Arch?
I've heard more than enough. You asked for it, you got it.
A sty, that's what it is. Nothing but a pigsty. A people sty,
had it. Undeniably. Finally getting through to you, huh? Without a doubt. A lot of me is just as bad as a lot of them. You said it. So, what's to do now?
Nothing else to do but put it back the way it was.
Just like that?
Just like that. Mind over matter. Concentrate. Go away, disappear, be extinct. Go away, disappear, be extinct. Go away, disappear, be extinct.
Hello, Mr. Beechcraft.
Why, hello, Laura. How nice to see you.
What?
Oh, nothing. Nothing. It's just good to have you back.
I haven't been anywhere.
No. No, no, of course not.
Hi, Mr. Beechcraft. I got your coffee. Miss Petty, Laura.
You didn't have to do that, Henry. Careful now.
Oh, Mr. Beechcraft, sir. Please forgive me.
You should be more... Forget it, Henry. Nothing serious.
It isn't?
Not at all. Just another little spill on the old sleeve. I'll take care of it with my handkerchief.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Beechcraft, for being so nice about it.
Tut-tut, my lad, tut-tut. Something else, Henry?
I was just wondering, sir.
Yes?
That book I gave you? Did you get anything out of it?
Not really. Why don't you take it back?
You sure?
Frankly, it's a lot of pap. Interesting, but totally unbelievable. And now, if you'll excuse me, I think I'll get back to work.
Mr. Archibald Beechcraft, a child of his time, a product of the population explosion, and an unwilling inheritor of the legacy of progress. A man who has just found out through trial and error that with all its faults, this may well be the best of all possible worlds, people notwithstanding. Tonight's case in point, in the Twilight Zone.
The Mind and the Matter, starring Hal Sparks, with Stacy Keach as your narrator, was adapted for radio by Dennis Etchison and written for The Twilight Zone by Rod Serling. Heard in the cast were Rich Komenick, Lisa Joyce, Jeff Lupitan, Doug James, Vince Amari, Meg Thalkin, Roderick Peoples, C.J. Amari, Roger Walsky, Karen Olson, Carl Amari, and Lynn Foley. The producers of The Twilight Zone wish to thank CBS Enterprises, Carol Serling, Dennis Etchison, Dick Brescia Associates, Claire Simon Casting, Terry Jennings, XM Satellite Radio, Sirius Satellite Radio, our sponsors, and our radio affiliates for helping make this series possible. This radio series is produced and directed by Carl Amari and Jason Mallow for Falcon Picture Group. Doug James speaking.